Hi, I am Maker Giovanni and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I will show you how we can save electricity and so save money on our utility bills with a simple DIY project. In fact, this summer I have built with very little money a smart energy meter, which allows us to measure the energy consumption of the whole house and see it from an app on our mobile phone. This, in my opinion, is essential if we want to start saving electricity, because it allows us to know how much energy we are consuming at a precise moment and how much we have consumed in the various days of the week, so that we can realize what consumes the most and maybe even the small power draws that we don't even notice. The device I've built uses a simple current clamp and a transformer to accurately measure the energy consumed in watt hours, as well as voltage, current, frequency and power factor. Through WiFi, the data is sent to the Home Assistant app, from which we can also see the charts showing the energy consumption trends over time. As icing on the cake, I also added a small display to visualize the data being collected. The project is quite simple, and most importantly does not require us to make major changes to the electrical wiring. But now, let's get started! This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. JLC PCB is a professional custom printed circuit board manufacturer that makes your PCBs in as little as 24 hours starting from just $2. JLC PCB also offers many other services, including 3D printing with different technologies and materials and assembly of the components on the PCB, so that we have it ready to use in our projects right away. To order your printed circuit boards, just go to the JLC PCB website, upload the Gerber files and select the different options to preview the PCB and proceed with the purchase. By going through the link in the video description, you can get $80 new user coupon for your PCB, PCBA, 3D printing orders and much more. When I started this project, it all seemed very easy. Take a current clamp, connect it to an ESP32, and you have power consumption data directly into Home Assistant. The problem is that it doesn't really work that way. After a bit of research, I discovered that measuring energy in AC is much more complicated than measuring it in DC. Long story short, in DC, to get the power consumption in watts, you simply multiply the voltage by the current. Instead, in AC, you have to take into account the power factor, which varies according to the type of the load. Here things get quite complicated, and I must admit that at this stage I was about to give up on this project. After a few days, somewhat by accident, looking on AliExpress, I found the solution, which after about a week arrived in this package. Inside we have products from Yanxian Meters, a Chinese company that makes very interesting energy measuring modules. In particular, we are going to use the JSY MK194G module for this project. In the box we have the module and its current clamp, which allows us to measure the current flowing on a wire. On the board there is also a transformer to safely measure the mains voltage, and another current clamp to measure the current on a second circuit, although we will not use it for this project. On the other side we have some integrated circuits, that starting from the values measured by the current clamp and the transformer accurately calculate the power drawn, along with the values of voltage, current, frequency and power factor. This data can be read by an Arduino or ESP32, using the TX and RX pins to communicate with the board through the Modbus protocol. Here comes in the other key part for this project, an ESP32 board. Using the Wi-Fi connection, this board will allow us to send the measured data to Home Assistant and view it from the app. To test the communication between the ESP32 and the energy meter, I connected 4 jumper wires to the terminals on the PCB. With these cables I connected VCC and ground to the 3.3V power supply of the ESP32, the TX terminal to pin 16 and the RX terminal to pin 17. Then I prepared a short extension cord with a plug, a socket and 3 wires for live, neutral and earth. With some terminals I derived 2 wires from line and neutral, which I connected to the LNN terminals of the energy meter. As a last thing, I installed the current clamp on the line wire going to the outlet. Before turning it on, however, we need to connect the ESP32 to Home Assistant using ESP Home. ESP Home directly supports the Modbus protocol that is used by the energy meter, so the code is quite simple. Anyway, since talking about the software is always a bit boring, if you are interested in the Home Assistant configuration, I will leave a detailed written guide in the description below. At this point, we just need to power up the ESP32 and, being very careful, plug in our circuit. On the Home Assistant app, I see the grid voltage detected by the module and the AC frequency, which as it should is exactly 50 Hz. Now we need to try connecting a load. First I tried with a 120W halogen lamp. With the lamp connected, on the app we also see the current in amps and the power drawn, which is about 120W. To calculate the power, the module also measures the power factor, which with a fully resistive load like a filament bulb is equal to 1. To do another test, I connected the vacuum cleaner. In this case the power is about 260W, and we also see that since the motor is an inductive load, the power factor is lower. Now that we know that the basic idea works, we need to turn this mess of wires into something that looks more like a finished product. First I cut a piece of paperboard, onto which I soldered the ESP32 using jumper connectors. Next to the ESP32 I put a 4-pin jumper connector to mount a screen, on which we will display the power consumption, voltage, current and the status of the Wi-Fi connection. The display I chose is a small OLED screen with I2C communication, which costs very little money and in my opinion adds something to the finished product. Then I put a 4-pin JST connector on the board to connect the energy meter, and two terminals with positive and negative to power the ESP32 with 5V. Once all the components were soldered, I made the connections under the board following the wiring diagram. For the connections I used some stiff copper wire and wires with silicone sheeting. And finally the board is done. The last part we need is a 5V power supply for the ESP32. The one I chose is very compact and has just two wires for the input and two for the output. Now that all the parts were ready, I designed the box to fit the whole thing to be 3D printed. As always, I spent some time on the design to take care of the aesthetic part of the project. For 3D printing, I chose some green PLA for the box and grey for the lid. Alternatively, you can use some tricks with video editing to make the parts come out directly from the screen. In any case, now that we have the 3D printed box, we can assemble the whole project. First I put some M3 threaded inserts in all the holes in the base using the soldering iron. Then I placed the board with the ESP32 in the box and marked the position to make two holes so that I could secure it to the threaded inserts with screws. With some more screws I also mounted the energy meter PCB and the 5V power supply. Moving on to the electrical connections, I connected the positive and negative of the power supply to the 5V terminals for the ESP32. Then I also connected ground, VCC, TX and RX of the energy meter to the ESP32. Now we are left with the mains voltage connections, and about this I want to remind you that working with mains voltage can be very dangerous, so pay a lot of attention and do everything at your own risk. To connect the energy meter to an electrical outlet, I salvaged this power cord with a 2-pin plug, which has a grommet on one end that fits perfectly into the 3D printed part. I joined the live and neutral of the power cable with the input of the power supply, and connected them to the LNN terminals of the energy meter. The connections are finished, and seeing these wires so neat always gives me such a great satisfaction. Now we need to install the cover, which has an opening onto which I glued the screen. To connect it to the board, I created a small extension cable with two jumper connectors and wires. Finally, I closed the lid with four screws. And here is our energy meter ready. In the end, I also quite like the design, with this wave pattern on the front of the box. The last thing to do is installing our energy meter in the apartment. As I wanted to measure the power consumption of the whole apartment, first I located the wires that go from the utility meter to the electrical panel that I have in my apartment. In my case, they pass through a box on the wall that is right below the panel. Once I located the main live cable, I installed the current clamp, and since it can be opened, it does not require disconnecting the cable. To do a test, I plugged in the energy meter, and as you can see on the screen, we already see the power consumption in watts, the voltage and the current flowing on the cable. For a more permanent setup, I pulled the current clamp cable through a conduit for about 3 meters, to get it into the cabinet where I also have my network switch. Here I mounted the energy meter on the wall, connected the current clamp cable and finally plugged it in. It's been a week now, and so far nothing has exploded. In the meantime, I created a dashboard for Home Assistant, in which I can see, in addition to the instant power consumption, a chart with the power consumption day by day, and one to see the consumption trend over an entire year. In addition, I have included a graph with the consumption over the last 24 hours, with also the minimum and maximum value of power consumption. For the nerds, there are also voltage, current, frequency and power factor values. Looking at the data on power consumption can be very interesting. For example, I found that the average consumption in a day is around 6 kWh, while the minimum power consumption that is reached when everything is turned off is about 60 watts, due to all the electronic devices that are connected 24 hours a day, such as the internet router. As you have seen, I've measured the energy consumption of the whole apartment, but if you have the electrical wiring divided into several sections, it can be very useful to measure the consumption of each section, for example lights or appliances. In that case, of the energy meter module that I used for my project, there is also a version with two current clamps instead of one, that allows you to measure the energy consumption on two different channels. And so this video ends here, and thank you very much for watching it until the end. If you are interested in electronics, check out my channel, and maybe subscribe. Bye, and we will see at the next video.